who tape CDs, DVDs to our publication Voices from His Excellent Glory, Declaring the Kingdom, write P.O. Box 21516, Hot Springs, Arkansas, zip 71903. Our website is www.LakeHamiltonBibleCamp.com and LHBCOnline.com. There are many hundreds of free audio files there. It's like going to Bible school at home. This is the 2015 Thanksgiving Camp Meeting being held at Lake Hamilton Bible Camp in Hot Springs National Park, Arkansas. Saturday morning, November the 28th, 2015. Callie Richey is a speaker of the morning teaching on the spirit of Python.
Well, Callie is going to come and teach us. Those of you that have heard her before, those that were at the women's conference know who she is. She has great words to give us. Great words of wisdom. Things that she has been through and been taken out of, she gives to us now. Callie, you can come. And Jane, you just came in. I just was telling people, I'm just thanking so much that you're there. Yes. You're here with us every camp, and you bless us. I know I don't get a chance to tell you that too much, but thank you. Thank you. No, just thank you for being here.
Good morning. Good to be here. I'm going to start off in prayer. Yahweh, our Father in heaven, we want to thank you for being our Abba Daddy. You are holy and you are pure. You are righteous and you are awesome. You are El Shaddai, our Savior and Deliverer. You, Jesus, are Lord of all. I confess that we have all sinned, but as born again sons and daughters, we have been given the righteousness of God in you, Christ Jesus. Your name is the name above all names. In your name and under your authority, I bind the strong man over myself and everyone here. I bind mind-blinding and heart-blinding spirits in Jesus' name. I bind deaf and dumb spirits in Jesus' name. I bind the Python spirit in Jesus' name. I bind the Antichrist spirit in Jesus' name. I bind every witch and warlock spirit in Jesus' name. I ask you, Father, to send your warring angels into the heavenlies and bind and cut off Apollo, Baal, Asherah, Jezebel, and her daughters, goddesses, and all fallen angels who would oppose this work. I repent for any pride amongst us and ask that you cut off Leviathan and all sons of pride. I ask this in Jesus' name. I bind all light spirits here in this atmosphere, as well as all witchcraft, sorcery, hexes, vexes, charms, and all ritual performed against this work in Jesus' name. I break the power of all visualization and every soulish prayer released against anyone here today and their families and all that pertains to them. I ask you to bless anyone who has committed those sins against God's people with godly sorrow that leads to repentance in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the anointing that destroys yokes. And thank you, Jesus, that you became manifest here on earth to destroy the works of the devil. I bind and forbid all false coverings and apply the blood of Jesus to every person here, especially to any wounds that are not yet healed. Let Yahweh arise and the enemy be scattered as civil war is loosed in the demonic camp. Lord, I surrender this ministry to you and invite you, Lord Jesus, to come and get the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. What I'm going to speak today on is the spirit of Python. And we're going to look at a little history. The history of the ancient city Delphi and the Greek god Apollo said to the son of Zeus. We want to understand the spiritual influence of this Python and where it came from. In this first part of this teaching, I want to establish some historical facts and biblical foundation. Who is Python? Where is it in the Bible? We will then move more deeply into the teaching on how to overcome the spiritual stronghold. In this article, we will also talk about spiritual apathy, depression, control, and other manifestations of this demon. Some of you may find yourself or your church in this teaching. I want to do three things in this teaching. Expose the spirit. What is the Python spirit? How does it attack and gain entry? And how do we overcome this demonic power? The first place that we see this spirit of Python in that term is in the book of Acts. In Acts 16:16-19, we read, "Now it happened, as we went to prayer, that a certain slave girl possessed with the spirit of divination met us, who brought her masters much profit by fortune telling. This girl followed Paul and us and cried out, saying, 'These men are the servants of the Most High God, who proclaim to us the way of salvation.' And this she did for many days. But Paul, greatly annoyed, turned and said to the spirit, 'I command you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her.' And he came out that very hour. But when her masters saw that their hope of profit was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to the authorities." In this passage of Scripture, the spirit of divination is literally translated spirit of Python in the Greek. And what is divination? Strong's number 4436, Puthon. From Putho, which is the name of the region where Delphi, the seat of the famous oracle, was located, a python. Example, by analogy with the supposed diviner there, inspiration, soothsaying, or witchcraft. What is divination? Divination is the art of obtaining secret knowledge, especially of the future. Is a pagan counterpart of prophecy. Careful comparisons of Scripture will reveal that inspirational divination is by a demonic power, whereas genuine prophecy is by the Spirit of God. The biblical attitude toward divination is completely hostile. In Deuteronomy 18:10, "There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or daughter to pass through the fire, or that useth divination, or an observer of times, or an enchanter, or a witch." Deuteronomy 18:11, "Or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer." Deuteronomy 18:12, "For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee." What is an enchanter? Strong's Hebrew 51:72, nakash, a primitive root properly to hiss. Example, whisperer, a magic spell, generally to prognosticate. This is the word used to describe the serpent in the Garden of Eden. This spirit of Python is the inspiration source of witchcraft and divination. To understand the working of the spirit, let us look at the famous oracle, which is a person, a priestess of ancient Greece, through whom a deity is believed to speak. A shrine in which a deity reveals hidden knowledge or the divine purpose through such a person. An answer or decision given by an oracle. A person given wise or authoritative decisions or opinions. An authoritative or wise expression or answer of Apollo in the ancient city of Delphi. It was probably in this region where Paul ministered, Acts 16:16, in the heavens, and the spiritual climate still ruled a spiritual stronghold and influence of Python. Just like when Paul preached in Ephesus, there still was a spiritual battle with the unknown gods and the goddess Diana. Acts 19:34-41. It was there that a riot broke out against Paul because of their worship of Artemis, the Greek goddess, sister to Apollo. What happened in this city with the possessed slave girl was a natural picture and manifestation of the ruling spirit in the region that went back thousands of years. Let's look at some of the spiritual history surrounding this region to understand this spirit of Python. The famous oracle, History of Delphi. In Greek mythology, Python was a serpent that dwelt in the caves of Mount Parnassus and was slain by the Greek god Apollo, and who then founded the sacred oracle at Delphi, or took it over from Python's guardianship. The pagan oracle of Delphi was located about 75 northwest of Athens on the Corinthian Sea, 5 miles inland and 10 miles south of Parnassus summit. There on the sharp Parnassus mountain cliffs at nearly 19,000 feet above the Corinthian Gulf, where the sacred spring Castalia flows into the Cephisus River, there was two spectacular crags that form on the ledge. The pagan temple of Apollo was located here. Steps at one corner reach the lower level of the temple, and it is said that intoxicating fumes rose from a cleft in the floor near the center of this chamber, which were believed to be the smell from the decaying python, which Apollo is said to have killed. Centuries before the birth of Christ, devout pilgrims made the arduous trek to Delphi to ask for advice from the famous oracle. City-states made generous contributions, some even establishing treasuries on the site. For more than 6 centuries, until the Christian emperor Arcadius in 398 CE destroyed the shrine, Delphi truly shaped the history of the world. Tradition has it that Delphi was found by Corydus, a shepherd boy who discovered that his sheep and goats acted strangely when they approached the area, and he himself soon began uttering prophetic statements which came true. However, the priestesses of Daphne gave oracle at Delphi during Cretan times, which were at least 200 years and possibly 400 years before Apollo. The shepherd Corydus obviously did not discover the site, but rather he uncovered the secret to the priestesses of the serpent of oracles of Mother Goddess who presided there. Christian sources assert that the priestess at Delphi, Pythoness, was intoxicated by fumes escaping from the underground cavern, and that she spoke gibberish, false tongues, which had to be interpreted by the priest, and further, that the question had to be formed so as to receive a yes or a no answer. What is Pythoness? Priestess. Any woman supposed to be possessed of the spirit of prophecy, a witch and a familiar spirit. Pythonism. Divination, diving, augury, soothsaying, fortune-telling, crystal gazing, astrology, and or sorcery. People came from all over the world to receive direction and revelation. The priestess Pythion would breathe in these fumes that came up from the ground, which some even call the prophetic spirit of Apollo, to receive their secret knowledge. Woman priestesses would be possessed much like a medium today, and some say that without control and even in a state of trance, they would speak. The people truly believe that the god Apollo spoke through the oracle, merely using her vocal cords to express his wishes and advice. Witchcraft, divination, was founded on the python worship. The snake was worshipped for thousands of years before Apollo established his famous oracle and temple, and was the very symbol of this region. One other interesting note about the Greek god Apollo, which we know is a demon that expressed itself as many other strongholds in ancient mythology, was also known known of as the God of healing diseases. I find it very interesting that even today, the natural symbol of medical healing is a serpent. Even in Numbers 21, when sickness strikes the Israelites, it comes with serpents. And when God instructs Moses about the remedy, it is a bronze serpent on a pole. Later, this pole was destroyed as Israel began to worship it. Even though in ancient Egypt and still places today, the most commonly worshipped snake is a cobra, there is a connection to infirmity and the spirit of Python. The spirit of Python has found its strength today in a generation that is hungry and looking for the supernatural in fortune tellers, psychics, tarot cards, readers, Harry Potter, Twilight, movies, New Age movement, witchcraft crystals, satanic music, mediums on TV, false religion, TM mediums, and more. There is even a mixture in the church today, like in King Saul's day. When there is no word of the Lord or prophetic vision in the land and people need direction, they sometimes turn to a false source of revelation like King Saul and call the psychic hotlines or allow their children to watch Harry Potter or Pokemon movies. Maybe they do a little yoga or read the horoscopes. There are many forms of witchcraft and Christian control, manipulation, and rebellion in the church today. In 1 Samuel 15 and verse 23 in the Amplified, "For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as idolatry and teraphim or iniquity." So how does the spirit operate? And what can we do to overcome its power? The spirit of Python works with the spirit of Jezebel. We know that Jezebel not only uses witchcraft, but also promotes and sets a platform for the false prophets of Baal and witchcraft in the land. This spirit serves the agenda of Jezebel and is a major source of demonic divination and witchcraft. People today are deceived by the increase of the supernatural, and some would say, "What is wrong with a psychic or a medium?" People would say, "What about the proven track record of many psychics and how they've even helped solve police crimes and bring hope to ones who have lost their loved ones?" Many psychics and those who practice various forms of divination may be true in many of their predictions and even accurate in their prophetic readings. Even in Acts 16, the possessed girl spoke the truth about Paul. Acts 16:17. "This girl followed Paul and us and cried out, saying, 'These men are the servants of the Most High God who proclaim us the way of salvation.' But look at what God says in Deuteronomy 18:10. There shall not be found among you anyone that maketh his son or his daughter to pass through the fire, or to the uses of divination, or an observer of the times, or an enchanter, or a witch." God alone is the source of all true prophecy and revelation. It was not so much what the slave girl said that was wrong, but the spirit in which she spoke. When you deal with the devil, you always lose. Hear the word of the Lord again, Deuteronomy 18, 11 through 14, as it continues from verse 10. "Or a charmer, or a consulter with familiar spirits, or a wizard, or a necromancer. For all that do these things are an abomination unto the Lord. And because of these abominations, the Lord thy God doth drive them out from before thee. Thou shalt be perfect with the Lord thy God. For these nations which thou shalt possess hearkened unto observers of times and unto diviners. But as for thee, the Lord thy God hath not suffered thee to do so." A revelation must come only from the Lord by the Holy Spirit. The Python history. I believe to better understand how this Python spirit attacks believers and the church today, we need to understand some physical facts about this snake before diving it into a more spiritual understanding. Let's look at the snake in the natural, the python, a genus of very large, non-poisonous snakes of Burma, Indo, China, India, Mexico, Asia, Africa, the tropics, and beyond. These snakes are known to crush their prey to death and kill by suffocation. There are several different types of pythons, and some of these larger pythons are often confused with the boas. Its various species are found throughout the tropics of the world. Some have reported to be 30 feet or more and 200 to 250 pounds. Adults are typically between 15 to 20 feet long. However, different geographic locations have different lengths, some as small as 10 to 12 feet, and others which will grow to over 20 feet. Adults are very large, powerful snakes. It is not uncommon to see a python that is over 20 feet to weigh up to 250 pounds. Typical 15-foot python will weigh between 70 and 100 pounds. Killing of the prey happens by constriction and suffocation. When a python has you in its grips, each time you breathe, the grip tightens with each breath. Some have said the death process is slow. And when a python has you in its grip, the only way to kill it is by cutting off its head. When the python attacks, one or more coils of the body are thrown around the victim, following up the stroke of the head, and the powerful body muscles apply pressure. The pressure exerted by a large python must be terrific. The prey is killed, however, by suffocating rather than by an actual crushing of the ribs. According to the Encyclopedia Britannica and the Hellenistic ancient Greek belief, the python was a spirit which possessed certain persons and prophesied unknown to them through their mouth, like a ventriloquist without control of the body. In the literal Greek and Hebrew translation, a serpent is a whisperer, a magic spell to prognosticate, divine enchanter, enchantment, learned by experience, indeed, and diligently observe how a python spirit attacks by control. The spirit wants you to keep you from doing what God wants you to do. This is achieved best by the strategy of spiritual apathy. Python wants to quench through suffocation the life and breath of God from your lungs and crush your hopes, visions, and dreams. Proverbs 28:18. Where there is no vision, the people perish. They become lazy and complacent. If the devil can crush your hopes, faith, visions, and dreams, then you will not have the fire you need to press on to the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. The devil wants to get your drive, your motivation, and your fight. This is achieved in many different ways. One in which the devil will whisper in your ears lies, accusations, condemnation, fear, and unbelief. In Psalm 74:14, it talks about cutting the heads of the sea serpents and feeding it to the people in the wilderness. Psalm 74:13, by your power you made a path through the sea and you smashed the head of the sea monster. Psalm 74:14, you crushed the heads of the monster Leviathan, then fed him to wild creatures in the desert. We must battle this spirit with the word of God and the name of Jesus in order to break the power of apathy and despair closely linked to depression and the spirit of heaviness. The devil always attacks us with words, like in the Garden of Eden in Genesis 3, with the great question, has God indeed said? The devil is always casting doubt and suspicion on God's word. And if we listen long enough, We can be deceived of our inheritance, lose heart, and give up. The spirit of Python and drugs. This spirit also works against those bound with addictions, particularly smoking or drugs. That a spirit of Python binds them, especially those who have used the hallucinant drugs like LSD, acid, mushrooms, PCP, angel dust, and I would say crack cocaine and methamphetamine. During the oracle at Delphi, formerly Pytho, the priestess would even use a leaf called a laurel. The leaves were a mildly poisonous plant taken in small amounts that produced prophetic hallucinations at the place of the oracle. In scripture, we see the root word for medicines, pharmaceutical, is found in sorcery and witchcraft. Sorcery in the Greek is translated pharmakia. In Strong 53:31 says, compare pharmacy and pharmacist. Revelations 9:21, neither repented they of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, nor of their thefts. Generally described as the use of medicine, drugs, or spells. Later the word was used of poisoning and then of sorcery accompanied by drugs, incantations, charms, and magic. This spirit can come in with ancient spiritual healing methods like acupuncture, Reiki, and New Age counterparts. The Python can bring apathy. It manifests with a sluggish weight during worship and weighs heavy on the countenance of the people in meetings. It brings hopelessness and despair in their eyes. Python attacks in this way, squeezing the life, breath, and joy of the Lord from our lives. It can be difficult to feel the Lord's presence. Imagine in the natural carrying around a 200-pound snake on your shoulders and how that would weigh you down and make you sluggish. One of the devil's number one attacks is hopelessness, despair, discouragement, and depression. It weighs you down, and it makes you tired. Python and God's promise. Take a look at the book of Numbers 13, when the 12 spies were sent in to spy out the land of promise. They returned with a bad report because of the giants in the land. Numbers 13:32. And they brought up an evil report of the land, which they had searched into the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. And all of the people that we saw in it are men of great stature. Numbers 13:22. And they ascended by the south and came unto Hebron, where Ahiman, Sheshai, and Talmai, the children of Anak, were. Their hearts had melted at the giants of Anak in the land. And they said in Numbers 13:28, nevertheless, the people be strong that dwell in the land, and the cities are walled and very great. And moreover, we saw the children of Anak there. They also said in Numbers 13:33, and there we saw the giants, the sons of Anak, which come of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers, and so we were in their sight. Even though God had promised in Numbers 13:2, send thou men that they may search the land of Canaan, which I give unto the children of Israel. It was a done deal, God promised, but because of their perspective of the situation and the way it looked in the natural, fear and discouragement gripped their heart, and they got into unbelief at God's promise and did not enter into the prophetic promise. Just like us today, we have promises from God, and we fail to enter into because of discouragement and our perspective of our circumstances. This is the way the spirit of Python crushes our faith, vision, hope, and dreams. Through discouragement, he causes depression, a sense of hopelessness, and despair. Depression and the spirit of heaviness brings infirmity, defeat, and sickness. Proverbs 28:29-18. Where my people have no vision, they perish or become lazy and complacent, is the word here. Spiritual apathy is no fight or drive to possess the promises of God. Remember that the strategy of the spirit of Python is to crush and suffocate the fire and life of God, using constriction and squeezing hope out of our hearts. Python wants to choke out the promise through strangling, using the power of hopelessness and discouragement. The very Hebrew translation of the word Anak for the giants in the land is to choke as with the strangulation using a necklace. Sometime we come to such a place in the warfare associated with this spirit and its slow death process and constant feeling of weighing down. Some even want to commit suicide to end the pain. The spirit of infirmity and death. The spirit of Python is also closely linked to the spirit of infirmity and death. In ancient mythology, the Greek god Apollo was the god of healing disease. We established earlier a close link in some countries, even to this day, where the python or cobra is looked to for healing. We see this spirit at work in those who have received treatment for healing by pursuing the ancient arts of magic and divination to alleviate pain. When a python has you in its grip, its intent is death, and it can be a slow process. The spirit of Python can also be at work when dealing with individuals that have come from a controlling or out from under an unholy religious relationship or background where witchcraft and manipulation were used. The spirit is often at work in those who have been plagued with a lifetime of infirmity. Python stirs up and connects itself in church members as well as in the community, city, and state, with ambition, greed, gossip, rebellion, ungodly authority and control, slander, lies, and manipulation, brutality and being unmerciful toward godly leaders, constricting, tightening, and shutting down life and ministry. It loves to hang around and use money to manipulate authority in order to prevent a move of the Holy Spirit. Python's spirit especially resists worship, prayer, prophetic intercession, apostolic anointing, and true revelation. It will try and create lethargy and a prayerlessness and an inability to worship. When manifesting through unwitting people in church, the prophetic person is a mix, operating in legitimate prophetic and then demonic. We absolutely need God's prophetic word in which He uses His children to speak to His children, but we are to test every word by the Word of God and the Spirit of God. In 1 John 4:1, God says, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world." Without being judgmental or having a critical spirit, we are to test every word said to be from the Lord every time. Bind the enemy and say, "Lord, is that true? Is that from you? And is that for me?" Trust the Lord and refuse the enemy. Before we pray against the spirit and receive deliverance from the Lord, let us consider the following and repent where needed. So if any of this stuff I hear, I'm reading, you see in yourself, just repent. Do we take all of our negative, defeated thoughts captive and bring them into the obedience of Christ the way we know the Bible says to? Do we resist the devil when he lies to us? Or do we buy into it and bow to the deception, responding to the garbage with self-pity, bitterness, resentment, or unforgiveness? Do we rise up in self-defense when offended, violated, big or small? Pride? Are we sexually pure? Do we look? Do we fantasize? Do we self-gratify? Are we provocative or immodest? Are we lovers of pleasure, food, entertainment, sex, more so than God? Are we vain, desperate to look good, and have others know it? Do we truly believe God loves us? Do we feel it, not just know it in our heads? Do we worry, even a little, about the things we wear or eat or bills in the future? Do we really trust God so much that the cares of the world roll off our backs? Are we truly wearing the full armor of God like He tells us to? Are we more eager to please our loved ones, friends, and our boss than we are God? Do we love anything more than God, such as our career, our desperation to succeed, our children, our exercising, our clean house, and yes, even our ministry, our destiny? These all have a place, even prominence, but must not replace loving God. This is sneaky idolatry because it is so hard to recognize. Are we certain and fully know God's love even in our souls so well that even if our worlds caved in around us and we were in agony, we would still praise Him and thank Him for His sovereignty, His perfection, His holiness, despite the ugliness around us that He permits? If the Lord has shown you sin in any of these areas or any other area, take a moment to repent. Now, all who are ready to pray, please pray with me now. Y'all can just repeat after me. Father, I come to you now through the blood of Jesus who has saved my soul. I thank you for your loving kindness and tender mercies which are renewed every morning. I repent on behalf of me and my ancestors for control, manipulation, pressuring people, squeezing people to get my way, being manipulative, false prophecy, gossip, slander, rebellion to authority, operating in your gifts while in rebellion. I confess the sin of my ancestors, my parents, and my own sin of manipulation and control and pressure and of cooperating with the Jezebel spirit and the Python spirit. Forgive me, Lord. I choose to forgive and release myself, all my ancestors, and any authority for their sin and cooperation with Python, which brought negative consequences into my life. I ask you to forgive me for the sin of Python, for yielding to it, and to the resulting curses. And I receive your forgiveness. I renounce the sin and the curses of Python. I break this power from my life and the lives of my children through the redemptive work of Christ on the cross. I receive God's freedom from this sin and the resulting curses. And I receive the authority and the citizenship that Jesus Christ has given me. I confess any sin of believing the lie that controlling and pressurizing people and manipulating people are normal. It's not. I forgive those who have contributed to the forming of this ungodly stronghold. I ask you, Lord, to forgive me for receiving this lie, for living my life based on it, and for any way that I have judged others because of it. I receive your forgiveness and your cleansing. I renounce and break now my agreement with Python spirits. I cancel any agreement with the kingdom of darkness. I break all agreements that I have made with this demon and all light spirits. And I choose to accept, believe, and receive the truth that love is greater. God is greater. I receive the truth that where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. I now submit to you, Lord Jesus, and agree that every evil spirit that you have ordained to leave me has to leave me as you work your deliverance in my life. Those called by name and those not called specifically, but whose legal rights are broken, must leave in Jesus' name. Okay, I'm going to start calling out some spirits, and y'all just will them out. Just will them out. In the name of Jesus, I command lethargy, defeat cycle, and defeat to go. In Jesus' name, I break your power. Come out of God's people. Hopelessness, poverty. Opportunity stealer, go in Jesus' name. Suffocating, come out. Come out in Jesus' name. Constrictor, spirits of barricade, paralyzed, come out in Jesus' name. Poverty, powerlessness, go in Jesus' name. Spirit of limitation, I break your power in the name of Jesus. Spirits that trap God's people, go in Jesus' name. I break your power in Jesus' name. Spirits that wall in, come down in Jesus' name. Come out. Come down and come out in Jesus' name. Unmotivated, come out of God's people. Procrastination, lack of ambition, go in Jesus' name. Lack of focus, go in Jesus' name. Aimless, come out in Jesus' name. Indifference, apathy, consistent weariness, go in Jesus' name. Come out of God's people. I break your power and command you to leave right now in Jesus' name. Suicide, go in Jesus' name. Isolation and depression, come out of God's people in Jesus' name. Come out in Jesus' name. Spirits that hinder worship, come out in Jesus' name. We break your power in Jesus' name. Spirits that hinder studying of the Word, come out in Jesus' name. Spirits that hinder worship and prayer, come out. We break your power in Jesus' name. Inferior, inadequacy, self-loathing, we break your power. Come out in Jesus' name. Disappointment, loser, unloved, we break your power. Come out in Jesus' name. Overlooked, unrecognized, go in Jesus' name. We break your power in Jesus' name. Repetitive rejection, we break your power and command you to go now in Jesus' name. Belittling spirit, controlling and rigid, you have to go in Jesus' name. We break your power now in Jesus' name. Come out in Jesus' name. Intimidating, manipulative spirits, go in Jesus' name. We break your power, you have to go in Jesus' name. Condescending, go. Critical spirit, go in Jesus' name. Squashing spirit, spirits that squash, we command you to go in Jesus' name. Despise, you have to go in Jesus' name. Spirits that block affirmation, we command you to leave in Jesus' name. We break your power. Devalued, neglected, and abused, we command you to go in Jesus' name. We break your power, the power of abuse, go, neglected, go, devalued, get out in Jesus' name. Verbal, sexual, and emotional abuse has to go in Jesus' name. We break your power in Jesus' name. We command you to go. Repetitive loss, repetitive violation, we command you to leave God's people now in Jesus' name. Repetitive trauma, we command you to leave. We break your power, trauma, command you to go. Repetitive destruction, we command you to go. Hypothyroid, adrenaline fatigue, heart disease, clinical depression, diabetes, go in Jesus' name. We break your power. We break your power now in Jesus' name. Get out in Jesus' name. All spirits of infirmity, related to Python. We break your power and command you to come out of God's people. In Jesus' name. Come up. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. All squatters, come out in Jesus' name. Anything that was not called that squat in, that your legal rights are broken to, come out in Jesus' name. Come out in Jesus' name. Alright. Feel a release. Just raise your hands up to the Lord. And thank you, Lord, for your deliverance. Thank you that I'm free. Thank you that I'm free, Lord. Bless you, Lord. We love you. Thank you for freedom. Now in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for filling me up. Filling us up, Lord. Every place that the enemy has left, we thank you for filling us up with your spirit. And we thank you for perpetual deliverance, Lord. Perpetual deliverance. We thank you that you just continue your work in us, Lord. And if you bring anything to mind, that you'll quicken us to deal with it. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, we just love you so much. We thank you for your love for us. We just thank you, Lord, for what you're doing in our lives and that we can walk in freedom. We don't have to walk bound up. We don't have to walk around with chains, Lord. Just thank you for what you're doing, Lord. Lord, I just ask you to bless your people in Jesus' name.
Just those of you who have been delivered, just continue to praise His name. And thank Him for your deliverance. Thank Him for your freedom. Set free from things that have bound you for years. Thank God, brother. You are set free. We thank you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We give you glory, Lord, for that. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we give thanks unto you for all the great things you do for us. We praise you and we glorify you for all things. All things come from you. And we praise you, Lord. Lord, we thank you for the food this afternoon, for the lunch that you're going to give us. I bless that lunch and I praise you, Lord, for it. In the name of Jesus, amen. You are dismissed.
This is the end of this message. Our website is www.LakeHamiltonBibleCamp.com and LHBCOnline.com. There are many hundreds of free audio files there. It's like going to Bible school at home. Thank you.